Now, Pakistan wrongly abducted and arrested Kulbhushan Jadhav from Iran. It committed gross violations of human rights. And our next report revisits the ordeal Kulbhushan Jadhav has had to face since his capture. Have a look.
Kulbhushan Jadhav has seen better days. He lived in Mumbai, a married man with two children. After serving the Indian Navy for more than 12 years, Jadhav decided to seek retirement. He set up a business in Iran and was working at the Chabahar port. But 3 years ago, Jadhav's life was hit by a major storm. He was picked up by Pakistan, charged with spying and sentenced to death. In March 2016, Pakistan claimed that Kulbhushan Jadhav was arrested in Balochistan. Islamabad claimed that he was trying to fuel unrest in the rest of region. He was given no legal representation to defend himself against the trumped-up charges. A military court pronounced the death sentence almost a year after Jadhav's arrest. Pakistan paid no heed to the fact that Kulbhushan Jadhav is an Indian citizen. India's demands for consular access were denied a total of 16 times. Instead, Pakistan released a video of Jadhav making alleged confessions. Apparently, these statements were recorded under duress. These forced confessions were used to create a false narrative. Pakistan tried to blame India for espionage. India said that this is a case of premeditated murder and moved the International Court of Justice.
Jadhav's continued custody without consular access should be declared unlawful. And, amongst other things, considering the trauma to which he has been subjected for over 3 years, it would be in the interest of justice, of making human rights a reality, to direct his release.
Pakistan's repeated violations of the Vienna Convention were now out in the open. While the hearings at the ICJ were on, Pakistan issued visas to the family of Kulbhushan Jadhav. But this was no humanitarian gesture. The meeting between Kulbhushan Jadhav and his family was used by Pakistan to further its propaganda. Jadhav's family faced a lot of harassment in Islamabad. The mother and wife were forced to change their clothes. Jadhav's mother was not allowed to speak to her son in Marathi. India's Deputy High Commissioner, who had accompanied the family, was initially kept away. Only after the diplomat protested was he allowed in. Outside, the Jadhavs faced even more harassment. They were heckled by the Pakistani media, who hurled false and motivated accusations against Jadhav. India's then External Affairs Minister highlighted the family's trauma in Parliament.
लेकिन सच्चाई तो ये है कि मानवता और सद्भाव के नाम पर हुई इस मीटिंग में मानवता भी गायब थी और सद्भाव भी गायब था. इस मीटिंग में तो केवल जाधव के परिवार वालों के मानवाधिकारों का उल्लंघन पर उल्लंघन ही हो रहा था.
Kulbhushan Jadhav has been a prisoner of Pakistan for more than 3 years now. During this time, Islamabad released a total of 3 videos of Kulbhushan Jadhav. It's clear now that Pakistan used the Jadhav case to camouflage its own misdeeds. Pakistan blamed India for the situation in Balochistan. It was a rather poor attempt to hide the repeated human rights violations by the Pakistani army.